Welcome back. You're still watching Today here on ENCA. Now, SASCO has declared a national shutdown of all institutions of higher learning. This follows a week of students demonstrating for equal access to higher education. The student organization says it will shut down institutions until several of its demands are met. Among these is the clearing of historical debt. I'm joined now by SASCO President Bamanye Matiwane for more. Thank you very much, President, for your time here on ENCA. Now, we know that your main demand as students is fee-free higher education. This is something that students have been protesting about since 2015, something that the ANC government has promised before it was elected govern the country. What's the way forward here? It seems you're not being listened to. 2015 is more than 5 years ago.
Thank you very much. Number one, we feel that the ANC government it does not prioritize education. Because even their cut of budget should have been clear that they are not going to cut from students. But they did so. They managed to do so. That is why we decided to fight. So we are still fighting. We are saying now, before all students to enter into institutions of higher learning, they must clear all their debt. That's number one. Number two, we are saying, allow all registration to be free. There are no students who must pay before they register, because the scenario that you find yourself in the institutions of higher learning, you are told that you must pay 50% of your debt before you register. And we know that many people have lost jobs, have been retrenched, but institutions of higher learning, they keep on doing the same thing as if everything is normal, which is not. So I say, there must be no business without these demands are met. We must fight till the bitter end. So we've met the ANC leadership. We've told them that there are no students who are going to pay for registration. And that is not going to happen while we are leading. So it's clear from tomorrow, we're shutting down all institutions of higher learning, be it universities and TVET, until all our demands are met. So that is our position in SAS. We are saying no to financial and academic exclusion. We are saying there must be a solid plan for missing middle students, because the criteria of NSFAS, which says if you are above 350,000, you must pay for yourself, which means those students are categorized as the students who are rich but too poor to fund themselves. But the minister would say, we do not have a plan on how to accommodate these students. So which becomes a problem to us to say, how do we start the academic year when you do not have a plan to secure and protect these students? And institutions of higher learning are saying, if you want to register, you must pay 50%. And they're saying, our parents no longer have jobs, so we can't pay, we don't have money. So they come to us and SASCO, we say, no, we're going to protect and fight, because anyway, education is supposed to be free in this country. We have declared in 2017, but now we feel that these comrades are putting us back, and literally they do not have an interest of giving us free education, which is a resolution of the African National Congress. So it becomes a
Let me jump in there for a little bit, Mr. Matiwane. You know, you speak about the resolution of the ANC. It's in their policy since 1994, their education policy. And we look at the fact that they always give the reasoning that the fiscus will not be able to afford fee-free higher education. They talk about government not having any money. But then you see what's happening at the State Capture Inquiry and the things that we're finding out about the ANC government and some of the corrupt members there.
No, it's part of what we're saying. Those who are corrupt, obvious, must be arrested. But there must be a concentration on education. I'm saying, how do you develop a country without education? In order to have a sustainable economy, you must prioritize education so that we can move forward and be able to have a stable country. But if you are not prioritizing education, we are going to be in a serious problem. These companies can't say that they do not have money. When we shut down the country in 2015, 2016, they managed to bring funds for NSFAS. So we can't say, there's no money now. They must go and find it the same way they are doing it for themselves. Mm. Because the state capture can prove to us that these communities can manage to get money wherever they are going to get it. Mm. So we can't prioritize our court on the basis that now they are saying there's no money while they are looting money. The money is in their houses. The money is with their girlfriends and their boyfriends. So we're not going to accept that. They must take that money and give it to us. Mm. And broader technical education. Mm.
Mr. Madiwani, we know that there are some student leaders who met yesterday, some of them saying on social media that the higher education minister tried to engage them and they walked out. How are your talks between government and different student leaders of different higher institutions of learning? If you're shutting down from tomorrow, I'm assuming the talks have been deadlocked.
Oh, thank you very much. You see, with the current of the ANC, we had said on our special NEC meeting to say, comrades, if the ANC can prioritize education, how are we going to convince students to vote for the ANC? Probably, maybe, let's start a conversation with the ANC to ask, is our relationship still there? Do you still prioritize us or not? It's a question that we're still going to engage the ANC in terms of the National Democratic Revolution. Yeah. To say, we engaged the ANC on Saturday, the officials, including the president. We are going to meet them on Monday again. But that does not say we must not shut down and fight, because these comrades can grumble you. Remember, these comrades are old. They've been here. They know all the tactics on how to manage young leaders. And we're not going to accept that. We had engaged the officials of SAUS as well, because we ought to respect, because they are in charge of SRCs. So we're set with them, we're engaged with them. I think we're agreeing, all of us. And called this young boy from the EFF, told him that this is a line of march. Let's go on the ground. We can't watch when our students are suffocated. We can't watch when our students are frustrated. You know, so it's a clear line of march. See, I'm a line song. We're fighting on the ground.
Just a quick one, very quickly to finish off, not too long an answer, but of course this is a student protest. So any journalist is, of course, welcome to cover a student protest. Am I correct?
Yes, yes, yes. No, you can come. You can come, but our priority is not the media. Our priority are the resolutions that are going to be taken. We want students' interests to be taken seriously as a clear line of march. Even with the ANC, we've told them that, comrades, you need to be serious now. Because it does not make sense to me. These comrades, they plan 2021, but they do not prioritize education. Up until we decide to go and fight, it is then they start to say, let's speak about students and their demands. Why?
Mr. Madiwani, thank you so much for your time. Unfortunately, we've run out of time. We will definitely see you in the streets tomorrow. That is, of course, the president of SASCO, Bamwanya Madiwani, speaking to us there about a national shutdown that they plan tomorrow. So no university or TVET college is expected to be open tomorrow.